Good morning, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Fireside Chat. In these times, it's also very, very close. It's important for us to be very close to our families, no matter how far or how close they are to us, while trying to look out for each other's health, not only of body, but also of soul. So, when we have an opportunity, especially to pray with our families, in these days, that's so central and key. This morning, Cardinal Piacenza, on behalf of the Apostolic Penitentiary in Rome and the Holy Father, issued a plenary indulgence for anybody who participates in viewing the Mass, praying the Rosary, reading Scripture, praying the Stations of the Cross through online social media. Or any general media under the usual conditions. So, in light of that, I am going to continue to do what I've been doing, not only to make sure that people have an opportunity to pray and to get all the graces that they need, but also to, because I know you need it, you know, and as a priest, I want to feed you. I want to be a good spiritual father to not only the parishioners that I have at St. Mary's, but all the people that I know. I know Father Maurer and Father Paul feel the same way. Our first reading today from Mass, it's taken from the book of Hosea. And Hosea is an interesting book because it speaks about God's love for Israel in a profound way, and it also speaks about Israel's infidelity and how God is faithful to Israel despite her infidelity. Hosea is asked by the Lord to take a prostitute by the name of Gomer as his wife. And that's symbolic of the relationship that God has with Israel in the time of the Old Testament. In this, that God espoused himself to Israel through covenant. And Israel was unfaithful to that covenant and engaged in idolatry. The sin of idolatry is not just only breaking a moral law, but it's a betrayal of a relationship. All sin involves a kind of idolatry, whether it be mortal or venial. And it's not just this arbitrary law, but I betray when I sin, no matter how small or great it may be. God's created order, and God's created order is rooted in love, in his own divine love. God's created order is a reflection of his truth, his beauty, his goodness, and his fatherly concern for his children, all of humanity created in his image and likeness, but all of creation in its own unique way reflects the goodness of God, the care of God, his presence. We hear in Hosea, "Return, O Israel, to the Lord your God. You have collapsed through your guilt. Take with your words and return to the Lord. Say to him, forgive all iniquity and receive what is good, that we may render offerings. We shall have no more our God to the work of our we shall say no more our God to the work of our hands, for in you the orphan finds compassion. I will heal their defections, says the Lord. I will love them freely, for my wrath is turned away from them. I will be like the dew for Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall strike root like a Lebanon cedar and put forth his shoots. His splendor shall be like the olive tree, and his fragrance like the Lebanon cedar. And they shall dwell in his shade and raise grain. They shall blossom like the vine, and his fame shall be like the wine of Lebanon. Israel, in her infidelity to God, put up obstacles to his love. Love is not just feelings, love is not just getting what I want. But love is giving myself as a gift, as Pope St. John Paul II says, but also St. Thomas Aquinas says, to love somebody is to will the good of another. to will their happiness, their fulfillment, their perfection, not as I see it, but, and not as they see it, but as God sees it. Israel will be freed, as Hosea said, from her idolatry. She will be purified and re-espouse the Lord. And that's hopeful for us, especially in this Lenten season, this unique, and also the unique Lent that is the coronavirus pandemic. God is faithful to us, and God could use anything to purify us. St. John of the Cross, in his Maxims of Life and Love, said, strip your heart of all desire, and you'll find what your heart truly longs for. And in essence, that's what the life of faith is about. That's what following Jesus is about. Allowing the Lord to strip our hearts in their most vulnerable state, in their most needy, wounded state, so that he can reanimate us by the power of his love and grace. That is at the heart of what God is. Of who God is. And that is at the heart of salvation history. And that is at the heart of the commandments. When we speak about the commandments and the law in Scripture, we have to differentiate between the ritual law of the Mosaic Covenant and the moral law. The moral law is the Ten Commandments. And the Ten Commandments are summarized with the two great commandments that we hear in the Gospel. That one of the scribes asked Jesus about is the first of all the commandments. And he says the Shema prayer from Deuteronomy. Jesus says, the first great commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the Lord alone, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. So the heart of faith, the heart of the gospel, the heart of the church is love, a communion of love. A love that purifies, a love that heals, a love that saves and elevates. And this is what God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit offers us through Christ in the church. That is why Christ set up a church. That is why to be faithful to Christ, we have to be part of his family. His family is the church. And the church is not just an NGO. It's not just a human organization. It is both human and divine. This is what the sacraments, this is what prayer, this is what the preaching of the gospel, evangelization, charitable, and united to that charitable works, all leads us to. But they must be rooted in authentic love of God and authentic love of neighbor first. Sin, idolatry, prevents us from loving God in the way that we should. There is idolatry proper, which is a violation of the first commandment, but then there is an aspect of idolatry, again, that encompasses every sin, whether mortal or venial. So something to ask I should ask myself during this time of Lent are, what are my idols? What are the things that I place in my life that I give a certain centrality or primacy to that maybe prevent me from loving God the way that I should and loving my family, my friends, my neighbors, my classmates, my teachers, my coworkers, my boss, strangers, the way I should? What are the baggages and the hurdles that I put in the way of that? And why do I do that? And in the end, yes, it's important to make resolutions to fight our sins. That is the proper dimension of asceticism, which is so important to the spiritual life, the life of faith. But it's not just making resolutions only. Our resolutions must be united to the love of God. To the love of God revealed to us through Christ Jesus in his passion, death, resurrection, extended to us through the sacraments, through the Eucharist especially, through confession, through baptism. When we unite ourselves to the Lord in prayer and through the sacramental life, He is able to purify us in the ordinary day-to-day grind, to strip our hearts of idolatry, so that we can find what we really long for. And ultimately, we long for God. Ultimately, we long to love God, but we go looking for God in all the wrong places. So we pray today. May give each and every one of us the grace of purity of heart and of healing, that He may heal within us those tendencies to give in to sin, those tendencies to give in to especially self-accusation, those tendencies to fall into a certain spiritual idolatry in the way we spend our time, whether it's with certain people, whether it's with certain technology, whether it's with food, whether it's with money, whether it's with our own ideas, our own pleasures, our own egos. And we ask for healing, healing by the power of His love, His grace, His mercy, so that we can truly enter into the power and divine majesty of His love that He wants to give us here and now. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Just a reminder, I will be live streaming the Stations of the Cross tonight around 7 p.m. for anybody who wishes to join online. God bless you.